Good afternoon and welcome back to the Bob Oaf and Caesar Oaf channel. Hello babes. So yeah, lots of things have been going on recently and this video has actually been a little bit of a long time coming. So I'm not actually going to be living in this place very much longer. I've had a Section 21 notice, which means the landlady wants to claim the property back. It's nothing to do with rent or anything like that. As you see, the property's absolutely fine. Hello C's, mate. Right, yeah, there's toys and that around and stuff. I've been packing and we've been playing, so there is a bit of toys and that on the floor, but that's nothing, you know. Right, yeah, so I've been pondering for this for quite a while, right? To be honest, living like this, under somebody else telling me how I should be and live my life, and it's really petty things. I really don't want to live like that anymore. And I've always wanted just to be kind of have my own freedom, do my own thing. If something's broken, fix it, make sure it's right, blah, blah, blah. And that isn't going to, I want to, obviously, I'm never going to get rid of my dog. And the prices of properties that with small gardens and help from the council hasn't been fantastic. So what do I do? I don't know. So I've been looking, I've been saving a little bit of money up and I've been thinking, well, what do I do? I'm going to live in a van, but it doesn't have a toilet and a shower. I can't keep clean. Maybe a horse box. Horse box was my first idea. But I looked into it quite a bit. And unfortunately, I decided that a horse box isn't for me because I'm not going to be able to drive, like, probably ever in my life. Partly because of my mental health conditions and partly because of my physical health conditions, which prevent me controlling my arms and stuff properly sometimes. Sorry, I just keep walking around when I'm talking. I find it easier. So what do I do? And then I thought, canal boat. A canal boat would be amazing. Maybe I could find an old shell of a canal boat, kit it out just so it's got a bed and somewhere to wash in it, and I'll figure it out on the way. And that is the dream. That is the absolute dream for me, is maybe finding a 40-foot, 35-foot canal boat and travel the UK's canals on a canal boat with me and C's, just travelling around, going and finding new fields and parks next to canals. And I know there is some, because on my journey of the 1,000-mile BMX tour I did across the country, I've seen loads of places I'd love to go back to. And I looked into it and I found, you know, canal boats, they're just too expensive. You need 5-6 grand. And I have no chance of saving that kind of money because I'm on benefits, low income. Caesar's got a few medical bills coming up. I'm going to have to dig into my savings for that. And I have barely saved any money. So what's left? So I just put boat in. And now I've never been on a boat. I've been on a little paddle boat in a little lake full of ducks and swans in Colchester. But I have never been on a boat. I've never been fishing. I've never welded anything. we'll get to that. But so what am I going to do with my life? Because I can't find a property for me and Caesar. It's time up. The eviction day was actually 2 days ago. Luckily, when you provided a Section 1 no fault notice, you do get an amount of time after that where they have to take you to court and get a court. It's all... It's so stupid that it even needs to go that far. But that is what needs to happen. So that's the law. That's just what it is. So what do I do? So I've been looking at boats, as I say, and land vehicles. Unfortunately, land vehicles and finding a bit of land to park on. Nearly impossible. There's so much stopping you doing some of the things you want, if you want to do them, if you can't drive, for example. So what is the last option for me? And that is a boat that goes sea. And I'm just on the way to look at a potential new home for me and Caesar. It is a sailboat. It is a metal sailboat. It is in dire need of serious restoration. So it's currently landlocked. But yeah, I'm on the way to go see that now. So I'm going to video the whole thing. And if this goes well, my YouTube is going to become slightly different than it is now, and I think that is something that desperately needed to happen anyway. I've not been happy doing what I'm doing, like the way I'm doing it, for quite a long time, and I've never known how to progress from that point. I have serious confidence issues. This video, I've been trying to record this for 4 hours. I'm up to 4:21, and I think I'm happy with what I've been saying so far, though. So I'm gonna go and have a look at this sailboat, and hopefully I think it's got enough room and it is going to be seaworthy one day. I'm going to put that, I'm going to live on that for a couple of years, hopefully, assuming everything goes well. I'm going to document the whole journey. And then, yeah, right, let's see how things go. Please continue to watch to the end. This should be very interesting. Peace out, y'all. See you on the move. We are here, mate. We have got to near Clacton.
At the boatyard.
Bob's going to be a pirate.
So we are here, mate. This is going to be Captain Bob's pirate ship. I'm going to go up, have a quick little look, and see you inside. It's raining, so I'm going to go and eat my Maccas in Bob's pirate ship, mate.
So in we go. It's the main area. Jesus, it is a lot bigger than I thought it was going to be, to be fair. Little kitchen area in here. Yes, mate. This wall's going to come out. And this one.
Oh, look, I can see out of here, mate. This is sick.
I'm almost.
Hello.
This is fun.
Oh, mate, this is nuts. I love it. I want it. I want it. I want it. I want it.
Feels dry. Yeah, yeah, you can go all the way through. Oh, there's the engine. Few batteries there, that's gonna come out. That whole engine's coming out. Be careful, there is a whole masting hole there. And that would
there's
be the
masting hole where?
Right there.
Oh,
this is gonna need to come out, all this is rotten. This is gonna be such a cool project. I can't want it. I want it, it's mine, I'm having it, I'll take it, mate! It's sold! Yes, mate. And it's my own home, you know?
Home time, don't you know?
I could show you how to defeat them now.
I think he wants me to shut up. I told him I loved him. Fuck that. I love you. This is our morning routine. Good morning, Facebooks. Don't get this every morning. I lay down with my drink and I get him. Yeah, be it, isn't it? Every single morning. I love you, baby. Best way to wake up. You're a big Caesar. Yeah. Like your big cuddles, didn't you, mate? Where are we going to go today? Should we go to the river? Should we go to the river? Both rivers. We can go both rivers. We're not going to be here for much longer, are we, baby? You'll see. Peace out. I'm going to enjoy 20 minutes cuddle with my boy, and then we're going to get ready for our walkies. Did I say that, did I? During cuddle time? Oh, no. See, he likes cuddle time that much. See you in the morning, people. See you in the morning. It is morning. See you in a few. It's an exciting day today. Really exciting. Please stay tuned.
Oh, good morning. Before afternoon, morning, and we're out on our morning little trot. And I thought I'd take you with me, show you where we go. We always go somewhere. There's different routes we take, actually. To be quite honest with you, he's gonna go for a turnip, so I'm gonna see you in a second. Told you. So we're back, and the funny thing is, I take two more steps. Look, I pick Caesars up because he does it in a bush, and then look at all this. In the middle of the pavement. Jeez, it's hard as well. Just give it a fucking kick with a stick. Do you know what I mean? Pick your shit up. Oh, I've got to rerun the camera after Caesar had a little... Had to go back to the bin and drop it all because it stank. So we're here now. You might. Won't be fields for much longer, G. We've got a surprise for the people today, haven't we, mate?
You're stud. Can't wait. When are you going to show me?
As soon as it's nearer, mate. Nearer. Here we go.
Can you remember when I first got Caesar for some of the original watchers? I was struggling on the lead. On. You wouldn't believe it's only 9 o'clock in the morning. It's not too UV intensive for him just yet. I'm wearing a coat still. Caesar, who loves Caesar? He's my geezer, a woman pleaser. Geezer. You're so cute when you sneeze, yeah? Caesar, geezer. Yeah, woman pleaser. Get your head in that bush. You get your head in that bush. We'll go back that way. Let's go back this way. Go back that way. That'd be nice. Welcome back. So this is one of our favourite spots. I think I've been here with you before a couple of times, to be fair. But yeah, we love it down here. Got a little bit, I just pop his lead on. Doesn't bother him at all. Lovely, see the occasional little fish swim past. Cool old, it's an old railway crossing bridge from right back in the day when House had a railway station. Shame it doesn't still, because it would have progressed a hell of a lot better and faster than it is. Barely see any rubbish down here. We did just see a bag and a bowl, but, you know, bag of sweets. But it's genuinely not as bad as some of the other places we go to. We always pick a couple of bits of rubbish up. Didn't take a bag with me today, actually, so that's a bit of a pain. There's a stream there. This is a clue, actually, to where I'm going to be living, which you will know by the end of the day. Little place there. I bet something sleeps under there. I would sleep under there if I was like a monk jack or something. Right, so we're just going to sit and enjoy for a little while. It's so secluded in a way, and if anyone comes, I know they're coming, so I can warn people. Psycho dog, psycho Bob. Psycho dog, crazy Bob. Woo-hoo. Right, yeah, and you've got the river walk over there. Still see people in that, it's cool. Right, see you soon. You up to? You going out there to nibble on that stick again? You ready? Keep walkies?